A special edition of Sam Choy's in the Kitchen. I'm John Veneri. This is world-renowned chef Sam Choy. We're visiting Cajun Two weatherman and Aloha Authentic host, Kamaka Pili.
I tell you what, I heard he has a beautiful outdoor facilities, him, the mom, the dad, the brother, and I tell you, we're ready to go.
It's the backyard barbecue version of Sam Choy's in the Kitchen.
All right.
After you, sir.
Yep.
Housekeeping!
Kamaka.
What's up, Uncle?
Air hugs, air hugs.
Air hug? Oh, the best room service ever. Come inside.
We'll stay distant. Show us to the back.
Yes, let's go.
Thank you for having us over, Kamaka.
Oh, this is my awesome pleasure.
Pleasure.
It is the greatest honor to have Mr. Uncle Sam Choy right here.
Thank you.
Had to clean the house for you guys.
What? So beautiful.
Wait, thank you. What about me?
Well, you forgot to take your slippers off before you came in, so.
Wow! So not right.
Was that the refrigerator today?
Yeah, this is the refrigerator.
I love it.
Shall we? I'll pass it on.
Yeah,
you want me to just show you what we got in here?
Bring it out.
Okay. And we're done. Okay, here we go. Uncle Sam.
Yes.
May I pass to you?
Oh man, some nice mushrooms, ginger.
Okay, so that was a personal request from my brother.
White eel.
White eel.
I love white eel, guys.
I can't wait to see what you're gonna do with it.
Okay, oh, here we man.
Go. I feel like I'm in the surgical room, but this is the
scalpel.
Here we go.
Potato.
Potatoes.
We got some garlic.
Garlic.
I'm feeling it.
I'm feeling it.
We gotta change up the vibe, right? We gotta make this outside look good.
Man, I think Auntie brought this hand-picked lettuce.
Straight from her garden.
Oh man. My granddaughter loved these baby cabbages. Brussels sprouts.
Okay, now,
my mom
okay,
loves
here,
that.
Here we go. Sip, hot. I know we're not supposed to be like, okay, there you go.
That's a good spaghetti squash.
Oh man, we're digging into the good stuff right now. Man, oh man.
So that was from last week.
What? Man, you guys.
We like to eat good, you know, Uncle. We learn a lot.
I wasn't invited.
True leftovers.
This is kind of embarrassing, you guys looking at leftovers, but I know that's what it's supposed to be.
My favorite.
It's like going through your laundry.
Yeah, it is.
I'm just taking, okay, yeah. This.
Oh.
Oh, baby, look it.
Man, unbelievable.
We're really gonna put you to the test today.
There's no test here, man. I cook with this kind of fish all the time.
We're not done yet.
Huh?
Time now for bok choy. This is bok choy. Everything in it, we have to use and incorporate into whatever Uncle Sam makes.
Oh, it's your special ingredient.
Yes.
So here we go. I'll pass it to you, Uncle Sam, excuse me. Yeah. I'll maintain my distance. So go ahead and give it a lift. Show the camera the ingredients. Okay.
Oh, perfect.
Black bean sauce.
Oh, that just changed the whole eel thing.
What is this one?
Really?
Oh, ulu chips.
Ulu chips.
I think that's what that one is. Cassava chips.
Cassava chips.
Teriyaki sauce.
Oh, teriyaki.
Cassava chips, okay.
And last but not least, I don't know what that is.
This is really good. Cassava.
So not only do we have cassava chips, we actually have raw cassava.
Raw cassava.
And I noticed the cassava is peeled.
Well, because if you have the skin, it's very poisonous.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're taking chances all
I love
the way
it.
Around.
Okay.
Yeah, we got
but this is good. This is good now.
That's good. It's clean.
All right. And that's it for bok choy. Okay, Uncle Sam, what are we going to do?
Take the seeds out.
Right.
And put it right on the grill.
Seeds out.
Scoop the seeds out. Use the wooden spoon.
Okay.
Kamaka?
Can I just use my hand since I got gloves on?
Yeah.
Actually, it's probably better with the
spoon. I'm going to take this white eel. I would say it's kind of hard nowadays to catch a white eel this.
That's bait right there.
Yeah, well, most guys use it for bait.
Yeah, what are you going to do with that?
I'm going to pickle it.
Pickle it.
Because mom had some pickling spice. And then I'm going to just, we're going to get some flour and we're going to pan fry it. I just got a little garlic going now. John's going to crush about four more garlic.
Four.
A little salt. Little vinegar. And look at this nice shot here. Now, technically, you would allow this to sit overnight, Kamaka.
Okay.
A little more garlic, John. Very good.
Okay.
And this gotta go in our fridge.
Okay. One more?
Yeah. Look at this.
Okay.
It's called art.
That is.
Oh, you're gonna put him inside? Oh, so fancy, huh?
Fancy.
That's good. Now close it.
Close it.
Okay.
Okay, add that in there. Sorry, away from you, go this way.
Okay. Celery.
Do you pour them in from the bowl or you go hand slowly?
Hand is fine. Okay. As long as you don't splash to you. Okay. Like now, where's my knife? John, did you take my knife? No, that's
right there. Right there by the grill.
Oh, sorry. Now, the cassava cooks quick. We're gonna get the salmon. Kamaka?
Yep.
You can get the salmon. Bring that right there, Kamaka. Who grilled the salmon? That looks
really
good.
This was my mom.
Beautiful. Mom did everything.
Mom is a good cook.
So we're gonna just break a little bit of the salmon like this. John,
okay.
Can you do me a favor and go get some of that beautiful Alaskan deadliest catch king salmon, king lobster,
king crab?
Crab meat?
Thank you.
I never thought about breaking the pieces so artistically.
And it's cold, so you don't have to worry at all.
Okay, so what I'm gonna have you do, okay. I'll show you how to take the meat out of that.
Yes, do show us the trick.
Okay, Kamaka, you can put that back in the cooler.
Okay.
Beautiful. Look at
that. Smells great. It's going to attract the state birds.
Well, that's how we got to go quick. John?
Okay, here you go. That sucker is connected.
Hook up, hook up, hook up! Take the meat off.
Okay.
Oh, my mouth watering already just with that.
Oh, man, look at this.
This is very rare where you'll find extra leftover crab legs in this house.
I was gonna say.
I think that was kind of like a purposeful thing. We knew this was coming about.
Okay, so you don't want to leave it in big chunks. Make sure you get all the fibers out.
Okay, all right. Only one, Uncle Sam? Just
okay.
One. Just no, one of these.
No. No, get a couple more.
Okay.
Look at all these beautiful crab meat. Salmon crab. This is Alaskan salmon salad, crab and call it Alaskan, because this got a lot of goodies from Alaska. Johnny, can you check the grill?
Sure, what am I looking for?
Oh man, beautiful.
That
looks real cool.
That's ready.
It looks really hot.
Okay,
and
wait.
Touching it like it was nothing.
Okay, we're gonna clear this place up real quick here,
okay.
John. Okay, Kamaka,
yep.
This can go in the fridge.
Okay.
That salad's ready.
Woo-hoo. Salad pow!
We're gonna take this out then. I'm gonna have you scrape this.
Okay.
Okay, because this is a spaghetti squash.
If you're gonna take them out to put them on the grill, why did you put it in the squash to begin with?
That's just my creativeness, you know? Just kind of like doing something.
Help it cook?
Yeah, help it cook, give it a little flavor in that.
Okay. Now what are we gonna do with that?
Okay, we're gonna let it cool a little bit because I know your hands can't handle the heat. This squash here, we're gonna saute it lightly with a little butter, a little salt, not too much. And then we're gonna let that be the bed of the steaks, gonna go right on top of that.
Oh man.
It's gonna be yow, wow, wow.
Okay. Dude, check this out.
That's why they call it spaghetti.
Yeah, right there.
I never did see that before.
Olive oil. Oh, this flavor is just amazing. Anytime you can roast a vegetable, it's just wow. This burner is really good. Where's Kamaka? Poor Kamaka.
Here you go, Uncle.
I know, he's back and forth, poor guy.
Beautiful. You guys hear that?
That is.
Yeah, you get a little gravy over here. You got a white claw.
We all got gravy. You got gravy too?
I don't got gravy, I got Western oil.
Ah!
Here it comes. Wait for it. Cowabunga, just a normal yield of the cassava plant, the potato of the tropics.
It is disease resistant. It is high fiber. It's healthy in starch.
and it thrives without pesticides or heavy maintenance on his 30-acre Hawaii Kai farm.
When there's no rain, cassava grow. When there's rain, it grow even better.
Cassava is a staple in the South Pacific, but it's used all over the world. In the West, we know it as tapioca.
Cassava flour is processed to make the pearls found in tapioca pudding or boba drinks. With a little help from the UH College of Tropical Agriculture, Alan has experimented with 415 different varieties. He and wife Gay Lin have created recipes for chips, bread, mochi, even cassava malasada, some of which is sold at their Saturday drive-through market. The demand always exceeds the supply. Alan's dream is to get the funding for a small factory to meet that demand.
This is where we can feed ourselves. We all believe in one thing, sustainable Hawaii.
Now back to Sam in the kitchen.
Cassava is a real popular thing out in the South Pacific, you know, like Polynesia, Papua New Guinea, all the islands. The first guy that ate it with the skin on, he took the bullet.
He found out. He found out it was poisonous.
But other than that, it's really good. You know, it's just spectacular good. Okay, so we're good. Nicely done, done, Kamaka.
I really want to impress you. And there's Tom inside.
Yeah.
Okay.
Look at that, evenly spread it out.
Bam!
Hey, oh, it's nice.
So the cassava here has completely soaked up the butter.
Right, that's done. We're gonna start staging this. We gotta stage this real quick. This is our bed of where we're gonna do that nice stir-fry steak. That's gonna go right on top of this.
Right on top of it.
Okay, John, just half and half. Beautiful. Nothing. Maybe half that.
So do you see this, that like your final presentation in your head, or do you like build it as you
That's
go?
That's a very good question. You know, a lot of young chefs, they kind of like vision that in their heads already. So the most important thing when you're cooking is looking at what you're gonna cook at a finished state. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You look at it, you go like, okay, I see it. Very nice, John. In the pan, we got tomatoes, onions, celery. We have a little bit of mushrooms and some garlic.
Okay.
And we have some ginger.
Ginger.
And then we're gonna add the steak.
The goods, the goods.
The goods.
Can I just say that this smells amazing? But you guys don't know that because there's no smell of vision, but it smells amazing.
It does smell amazing.
It's so good that it's going right through your mask, right? Okay.
Okay, now get some of Ted's because we gotta do this.
Ted's.
Teriyaki sauce. I don't know, John, you don't want this. This is really good.
Well, is it Ted's? I know.
Okay, that's it.
Just a little bit.
That's it.
You're just touching the top with it.
Yeah, because Mom did a great job in cooking a steak, so I don't want to take away from that.
Everybody's watching, John. Don't mess it up.
Beautiful. Wow, look at that. That's going to be a nice dish. No rice, but just the cassava, which is the starch, and the butternut squash, or the spaghetti squash.
So let's recap what you put inside there.
Rice wine vinegar.
Bingo.
Pinch of salt, pinch
Bingo.
Of pepper.
Okay.
Sugar, and now olive oil, blend.
And pop.
Hey, ola, o kalani.
Oh, can I say them? I don't remember the words of that one.
How the hell do you not remember it?
That's
I'm
the song
30
that
years
goes
out.
Every other year.
You're right.
Right? You're right.
Okay, we're good.
I can't believe we just made dressing. That's so cool.
Yeah.
Isn't that cool?
And then
you
never
can impress
that.
By doing it yourself.
Yeah, now you're gonna pour that right in that bowl.
Okay. Is there a sexy way of pouring this out?
High, go high, up.
Yeah, let it splash, let it splash. There you go.
Beautiful.
You did a good job there, Kamaka.
Thank you, thank you.
We got the salad, we got the steak and cassava, we got dressing, and now?
The eel and the fish.
Time for eel and fish.
Okay, what we did, we just seasoned the fish, the local fish here, and a little salt, that's it. And I got some oil going out real hot, and I'm searing it, that's all we're doing. I'm gonna finish it with a little black bean sauce, because we haven't used the black bean yet.
Okay.
The mid-pack black bean sauce.
Oh boy.
I don't know. You guys staying for lunch, right?
That scoring looks pretty good, doesn't it?
Beautiful, John.
Huh. Oh, that's gonna be good. Garlic and a little bit pa'akai.
Hey, fishy, fishy, fishy.
Oh yeah. Uno, dos.
Straight from the Alawai. Just joking,
We've had some really good tilapia on this show, I have to tell you that.
Okay, make sure the state birds don't land on it.
Ooh.
Here's all our eel.
Uh-huh. Is that still on?
No.
Anything particular you did with this? You just sliced it open,
flattened it out, and just kind of
floured
like
it up.
Filleted it out a little bit.
Any seasoning?
No salt? Oh, yeah, the pickling salt.
Oh, that's right, the pickling salt.
I got the
pickling spice, I mean. Yeah.
I got the bones and everything in here, so very, very good. Tasty. Tohei.
Well, it's the Aweoweo. Yeah, the Aweoweo eel.
Okay, John.
Yes, sir.
I want you to lay those three pieces of fish without getting the garlic off, right on this pan.
And cue music.
Baby shark, doo, 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 doo. Who made that song?
Some rich dude now.
Just that one song, man.
Okay.
Oh, look at this eel.
He said a little, but he's gonna say more.
See? Oh. Yeah, the three teaspoons,
Nothing like a little fried white eel.
See, that's the perfect right there.
This one. I don't even look like eel. I would never know.
Yeah, I would think fish.
Yeah.
Are you guys ready? We're done. Fine. We're done, right?
We're done, yeah.
It's time to
grind.
Time to
grind.
It's time to grind. Uncle Sam, let's recap.
We had some nice cassava.
Yeah, that came from the College of Tropical Agriculture.
And thank you guys very much for peeling it. It was already done. And then we had a nice spaghetti squash that we grilled with some baby Brussels sprouts. Grilled that off, sauteed it up later, put it on the bottom. We sauteed the steak with a little bit of Ted's teriyaki sauce, laid it right on top of that beautiful platter of cassava and spaghetti squash. And then we're really blessed to have Alaskan king crab legs and nice salmon that mom cooked. And auntie brought some nice green leaf lettuce.
Mm-hmm.
So we added that. We made a garlic vinaigrette that you were stirring like this, really nice. And then of course we had that famous white eel that I did a Portuguese kind of like a marinade, you know, pickling, spice, garlic, little rice wine vinegar we used. Little salt, little black pepper, marinated, dusted with flour, and pan-seared it.
Yeah, it came out super good.
And then we had three Aweoweos, which we pan-fried and put a little black bean sauce on it. And boy, let me tell you what, it was... Well, John, what do you think, John?
I think it's pretty darn good.
I gotta admit, though, I never ate eel before. So is there a special way you eat eel?
This one here is like pickled, so which is one of the best ways I like to cook it. You can also grill it. You can also cook it like in Polynesia. They'll cook it with coconut milk. You know what I'm saying? So that's another way they do it. And I like it this way, the Portuguese style.
And white eel.
Kamaka, for our viewers, go ahead and tell everybody about Aloha Authentic.
We give you poi, that's it. No, but Aloha Authentic, I mean, it started off as a show to kind of just find people and artists, really artisans, and hear what their story is and their message. But as we did this and we grew, the more interest of culture and speaking with our practitioners. So that's kind of what we've been doing lately, is just going around town and finding our own people to be the storytellers of our home and let them paint a picture of what authentic Hawaiian culture looks like or lifestyle.
Well, thank you for all of what you do, and thank you for having us.
Yeah. No, thank. I couldn't thank you guys more, because again, poi gets bland after a while. So this is a big surprise.
But remember,
when Sam Choi's in the kitchen,
you can do the cooking.
Chef Sam Choi.
Is our water boiling?
I'm gonna have to.
Kamaka, are you okay, Kamaka? Rolling,
down.
Rolling,
down.
Rolling down a river. Oh. Da, 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 da. Come on, John.